How's it going, everyone? It's Adam, or Yaddy Yaddy, and today I have a lifeguard tip video. I'm gonna give you guys 3 tips for you guys to help you survive and pass the lifeguarding course to become a lifeguard. Now, I know a lot of people are struggling to find out if they should take it, if they're good enough swimmers, so I'm gonna give you guys 3 simple tips. Now, before I get started, I've been a lifeguard for about 5 years. I got my certification when I was 15, so I was a sophomore in high school. So I was the youngest kid in my class, the most inexperienced kid ever, and I still passed and I still did a really good job. So I'm gonna give you guys my 3 tips right now. Tip number 1, this is more of a myth. You do not need to do swim team to become a lifeguard. Now, all these people think, oh, you gotta do butterfly, you gotta do like all these flip turns, all these crazy things that swimmers do on like swim teams and stuff. That is not true at all. A lot of my friends that are lifeguards and that I work with have never done swim team in your life. I haven't even done swim team. So don't worry about that. All you need to do is you need to be a good swimmer though, okay? This is not like a cheat saying, oh, I don't do swim team, I can do it, right? No, you still need to be a good swimmer. You still need to be very comfortable when it comes to front crawl and breaststroke, especially breaststroke, because you're gonna be swimming 12 laps, which is 300 yards. It's very tiring. And breaststroke's the easiest stroke to do long distances because it's just like so relaxing and it doesn't take a lot of energy. So definitely perfect your breaststroke and your front crawl. But if you're comfortable with both of those, you'll be completely fine. Also, treading water is extremely important because not only are you tested 2 minutes with no hands to tread water, you have to tread water in literally all of your rescues except for shallow water. You're gonna be picking up people that are like really heavy, or you have to hold a backboard while you're in deep water. So just be very comfortable in the pool. It should be effortless. If you struggle to tread water, I would not recommend taking this course right away. I would wait till you're very comfortable. Tip number 2, definitely make friends as soon as you get into your certification class or as soon as you get into a new pool job or a lifeguard job. Now, making friends and being with people that you're comfortable with, it's like easy to talk to, it makes it so much better because not only can you communicate with them and be partners with them, they can also help you out. Like they can kick for you, they can not go as deep on deep water rescues. It just makes it so much more fun and it's so much more easy because you don't wanna be stuck with a partner that's like 300 pounds you've never talked to and he's gonna go sink to the bottom of the pool and you have to go save him. So I definitely recommend making some friends in class. It'll make it so much easier and you'll definitely pass with them and it's just so much more fun. My final tip, this is more of a tip for people that are already lifeguards or have already passed the class, but it could definitely be used in the class as well. And it's trust yourself and just be a natural. In the real world or when you're really lifeguarding, you know, you could do every rescue by the textbook, like, all right, bend your knees, stick the rescue tube under the person's arms and stuff. But in reality, if a kid's drowning, it doesn't matter how they get out as long as they're okay, okay? I mean, it matters if they have a head injury, then you wanna do everything, like stabilize the head at all times. But if there's a little kid in the small pool and he's like, he sinks to the bottom and you just pull him up with your arm and he's okay, you know, it's okay. You don't need to freak about technique. Oh, I forget this rescue. I gotta think of which one it is from the Red Cross. It just you don't need to do that at all. Just trust yourself. And also when you're taking the class, just do whatever the instructor says, but just if you mess up, it's okay. They're not gonna care because you're new. You're taking the course for a reason. As long as you pass the pre-test and the swimming, the treading, and like the brick diving, whatever you do is fine. They'll help you improve it and you'll definitely become a lifeguard. Don't sweat about it. Unless you have a really bad instructor, then I recommend peacing out. But besides that, I hope you guys enjoyed. Definitely like the video. I'm gonna make more lifeguard videos just like this. I'm gonna vlog me and my friends while we're at work. So it'll be really chill, it'll be really fun. And you guys can see what it's like and how we like set everything up. And also help you guys be good lifeguards and really like enjoy yourselves. It's a very rewarding job. I definitely recommend becoming a lifeguard, especially through your high school years. It's the funnest job in the world, definitely during the summer. So thanks so much for watching. Like, subscribe. Hope you guys enjoy. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.